All right, welcome back. We're still in Pandora. And it occurs to me that I'm perhaps a bit behind in terms of their conversations and the ends. So I'm going to do one at the start of this episode.
Seeing Ellen in his true form gave me a new respect for magic power.
No kidding. She acted so young despite her real age.
Hey, bro?
What?
This Eleni witch wasn't always so scary, right?
No, I heard she was a typical old lady before.
Then it was the magic that made her into a terrifying bad guy, right? Hear me out. What if someone who was mean from the start got their hands on that kind of magic?
I guess they do even more harm out in the world.
Right? Then what would happen if Sis managed to get more magic powers?
Better not think about it. There's no way we'd manage to defeat something so sinister.
What are you guys implying?
Alright. And I'm still probably behind because they're talking about the witch. And we had just finished the setup with Thanatos in the ruins south of Pandora. So let's do this one more time.
One night is 10 minutes.
It's so weird talking to Luca. I can't wrap my head around the idea that she's hundreds of years old.
Never seen a granny like her.
First time we met, I didn't realize that was Luca until Gemma got mad at me.
What's her secret? Whoa! What's with the serious expression?
I don't care how old I get, as long as I never look like Eleni.
How does Luca manage?
I've got it! It must be the lake around the water palace.
Undine must have imbued it with magic or something.
That must be it! I'll just take up swimming in the lake every day and wait for the results.
Look out, world! This fresh-faced girl is gonna cause a splash!
What is she talking about this time?
I wasn't gonna ask.
You guys have something to say?
No, nothing.
There are some things we just don't need to wonder.
Alright, so they're talking about the magic now. Okay, we have one more to do, I guess. Burning all my money at this end.
I wish I could use magic. How come you guys get to do all that cool stuff?
I didn't realize you couldn't use magic as a wielder of the mana weapons.
Don't worry. We can clean up all those annoying enemies for you.
But I wanted to clean up enemies too.
Don't pout. I'll cast some magic on your weapon to make you feel better.
Yeah, as long as we help each other out, we'll be invincible.
What a nice sentiment. Leave the healing to me.
Good thing you didn't get attack magic, sis.
What? Why?
If you use too much strong magic, you'll turn into a scary witch for sure. Worse than Eleni.
And here I thought you were being nice. I take back everything I said before. Good luck healing yourself.
Come on, cut them some slack.
Oh, you're going to take their side? See if I heal you either.
Oh, man.
A lot of these seem to revolve around them pissing the girl off. You know, there's probably another one to do, but I'm getting tired of watching these, so let's move on. Alright, so we got our destination. Oh wait, no, I have some new weapon orbs, so I can go stop by Watts and get my crap upgraded.
Welcome, welcome. It's 50 GP.
Where the hell are we supposed to go now again? Oh, okay. We gotta go. Where are we? Underground Palace? Water Palace. We go Water Palace. Yeah, we do go Water Palace, don't we?
Welcome, welcome. The water.
Get a look at the overworld. Maybe it was the underground palace we were supposed to go. That's where Gemma was going. Now, we had already been there. But it was, No, not supposed to be here. I feel kind of bad for not remembering what I'm supposed to do right now. I don't think it's any different than it was back in the original game. Probably the same thing. I'm just not calling where I'm supposed to be exactly. Notice something. Head back down. Take a look at,
No way!
Okay, maybe it's not the case, and I was just sort of imagining it. But look over on the left side there. Oh, I mean, there's a town here. It's not where I meant to go. But, up on the left side of the map, we have a section in there. I mean, it's showing us the map up there. The world of the original game as a map. And of course, scaled down in size, so its low resolution isn't really an issue. But there's only so far out that you're capable of seeing on the actual game world. Now look at the trees and then the lake. It was a part of the world that you were never going to see, but since it's zoomed out so far on the map, can see out that far, so they just sort of mirrored everything. Everything's back reversed. Now up a little higher, it doesn't really show that same thing. They probably put a little more effort up there.
Maybe to make it not so obvious. Yeah.
I guess I could grind some experience points or something here.
Whoa! Ha!
started when I brought the camera back online. I was scared at this point. Running back. You know, it is kind of an irritating thing. Like, the first time you're making your way through this area, it makes perfect sense to have a grab around like this. Maybe take a little while for you to get through it, you know, fight the enemies. It can be challenging fighting these new bees and stuff. An area where you're probably alone, or you only have one character with you. You don't have high power weapons. You haven't reinforced your sword at all yet. So everything's harder as you're moving through this area. When you get to the point, though, when you're this far into the game, and you have to make this trip multiple times on account of the fact that this is where Watts is, you've got to run back and forth, you've got to circle around guys a bunch of times, and it does get kind of just not wear on you. Hey, there you are.
There you are. The Sea Thieves are below. They're after the mana seed in the underground palace. I'll handle the palace. I need you to see the things below. Keep your guard up. You don't know what enemies lie in wait for you down there.
All right.
Wait! There's no way back once you've gone down there. First, find the magic rope.
Oh, damn it, the magic rope. All right, where's the exit? Somewhere in this direction, I think. It's in this underground area. I think I bypassed the area where it might have been. Kill them in their sleep. Honestly, I don't remember the magic rope being a necessary thing in the original game. I mean, not to say that it wasn't. I remember getting it in all my playthroughs. Or I think I remember getting it in all my playthroughs. I'm pretty sure it wasn't necessary. In fact, you know what? I must not have done it. I mean, the magic rope is a bit of a convenience if you're deep in a dungeon and you need to get your ass out of there. The magic rope just sort of takes you to the exit.
Die.
Underground. Man, just throwing these orbs at us now, aren't they?
Aha! The water scene!
You know, I never pictured this character being female before.
How'd you get in here? You realize we ain't letting you leave now that you found our secret hideout, right?
I didn't picture these two other people being human, either. Always thought they were, like, some weird mutants or robots or some shit.
You brats have come to the right place. The Scorpion Army is gonna rule the world. That's us.
Aw, yeah.
Shut your pie hole. It was us who took your precious water seat.
I didn't know you'd taken it.
Now, thanks to Asafi's power, we've completed our super deluxe robot. We call it Kilroy the Indomitable.
Aw, yeah.
Take him out. Kilroy, activate.
On it, boss.
Emperor's weak point was up his back, but you couldn't really reach his back while attacking him from the front. But I guess the arc, your attack arc, is a little bit higher, a little bit longer in this game than it was in the original, like, attack it from the front. And just sort of, it can't be taken. I remember using the whip a lot when fighting this thing in the original. Other attacks and you'll get the thing stuck in some kind of attack animation. Why did I have to do that?
Oh, no. Won't get away with this!
Why are you letting them get away?
Let's bring this back to the Water Palace.
Yeah, let's bring it back to the Water Palace. But first, let's stop by Watts and get that whipboard forged.
I've been waiting!
Kind of weird that they let the sword and the spear get up to level 3 while the whip and the javelin were still at level 1. They're all dead. Stupid beast. I'd always considered it a kind of like a milestone in the original game when the enemies of Gaia's navel can be defeated with one regular charged hit. Just a 100% charge. If you could hit these enemies and then they die one hit, then that was a sign to me that you would pay a lot of progression, because they were such a pain in the ass in the original game. Here, the... I don't know, maybe they're trying to smooth out the difficulty spike. Still, somewhat early in the game. They don't want to be too difficult. The original game had a kind of unusual difficulty spike where... The game was probably
welcome,
at its hardest
the Water Palace, huh? Well, what?
The water magic. Because you didn't have any magic, especially the bosses getting just fight them straight with weapons and all that. And they jumped all around, and your characters didn't have to be able to heal with some candy. And, oh my god, it could be challenging. When I went to the Water Palace before, that was very useful. Supposed to go there, talk to Luca, and there you go. You hear the quarantine. Okay, so it's at level 3. Let's try it out. Kill it. I want to kill it. There we go. Haha. fast in the original game. I don't remember these guys throwing their weapons. Although, perhaps they did. Oh, yeah, they did. Having that spaced out is really nice. There are times I'll simply put those levels up, and I like to keep the spear high on. Let's switch it out. The spear was something that in some playthroughs of this game I went and I didn't reforge once for a while, even after I got the next orb. Because of that spaced out of it, you hit him, you space him out, it's actually really useful.
Now, Saint Luca!
Get out of here! No!
Well, well, who have we here? I'm Gestar of the Vandal Empire!
Hammer it up, buddy.
Hand over that seed if you want Luca to survive this encounter.
Don't do it! Just run!
I'm out of here.
I can't move! So glad to see the seed still safe and sound in this location. Now, I'll just break that. There. So glad we had this chat. You can take care of my pets as a reward for making it this far. Don't forget to feed him!
Alright, another boss battle. Oops, we're all good. Oh, no, we're not. Alright, let's do this properly. Oh, got water man. Keep everything alive. Got an achievement. Wow, I let this episode go on for too long. That weird pause is just... Hey, another bow orb. Hey, where the hell were you? Weren't you supposed to be a knight?
Rejoice, men! The Imperial forces have drawn back!
No thanks to you.
We managed to defeat their monsters in Pandora, too. One of them dropped this. You should take it.
Yeah, that's what those
the Empire is worth. We're running out of time. You need to restore the sword now. I'll return to my home country and do what I can to stop the Empire. If they manage to rebuild the fortress, the Mana Sword is the world's last hope. Talk to the cannon travel man in Pota. He'll be able to send you to the Upper Land.
Mountains and find Sage Jock. He will teach you the true courage of a hero. You must visit all 8 of the world's palaces and synchronize your sword with the Mana Sword. It will be a long and difficult journey.
Okay, there we go. Now, I just finished up out here. Now, let's haul ass back to someplace and... And stay and rest there, so we can get whatever that conversation is we're gonna have.
No way!
Get whatever conversation we're gonna have, and then we'll head to the Upper Land.
Welcome to Neko's. Do you need anything?
Expensive, but whatever.
You know, I still haven't forgiven you for that joke with Gnome earlier.
Huh?
Lighten up, sis. You're still worried about that?
It's a big deal to me. You know I only have eyes for dialogue.
I know. But Gnome didn't mean anything by it.
Besides, it's not like you're married to dialogue, right?
Of course not.
Well then, who cares?
I care. What if someone overheard and thought I was cheating on Dialog with a tiny sprite? If Dialog heard, he'd be devastated.
He'd probably understand that it was a joke.
You don't understand. You guys are forbidden from calling me Mrs. ever again.
Oh, hey, Gnome got me thinking about mana seeds, so I figured I'd ask. Can I taste the next one?
Don't taste it. The subject.
Okay, a lot of these are just them pissing her off.